Good evening, everyone, and welcome to Norristown High School. My name is Joe Hyland, and along with Bob Koch, we will be bringing you all the action here from the Norristown High School. Tonight's contest between the Norristown Eagles and the Quakertown Panthers. Another squad of Panthers are looming on the horizon for Norristown, and by that I mean the powerful Cheltenham Panthers. They will be growling at the Eagles in about 10 days from now. Tonight, we have a much less lethal pack of Panthers facing the Eagles this evening. Norristown comes into tonight's game with a record of 12-3, a sparkling 9-1 in conference play. As usual, the Eagles will be led by Danielle Marshall, who together with Sasha Sims, Tamara Halsey, and Ashley O'Donnell have the Eagles poised for their postseason playoff run. The Norristown's leading scorer is, of course, Danielle Marshall, averaging 17 points per game. The Eagles' leading rebounder is, surprisingly, Sasha Sims, who is picking up 7 rebounds per game, and their floor leader is, of course, Tamara Halsey, who is dishing out 7 assists per game. I hope the Eagles are a lot sharper this evening than they were in our last broadcast, a very lackluster win against an overmatched Methacton squad. In that game, it seemed like the Eagles did only what they had to do in order to win. And that's a dangerous habit to fall into, especially with the playoffs looming, when a winning effort will take 32 minutes of intense basketball. So I look for the Eagles to run this evening. I look for the Eagles to dominate the offensive and defensive boards. And I don't see Quakertown giving the Eagles a lot of trouble. But to bring you up to date on the Quakertown Panthers, my friend and colleague Bob Koch. Bob?
Thank you, Joe. Good evening, everybody. This game, I think, is going to be a very quick game in terms of who's going to win or lose. Norristown is going to come into this game, as Joe suggested, with, quite frankly, an opposite record on the part of Quakertown. Norristown is, you said, I think, 9-1 in
yes.
league play.
Yes.
Quakertown is 1-9 in league play, and they are 3-13 overall, and you said that Norristown was 12-3 overall,
that's
right?
Correct.
So both teams are in very different directions. Norristown's getting ready for the playoffs. Quakertown's probably getting ready for the end of the season. You indicated that Danielle Marshall's averaging 17 a game.
Yes.
The top leading scorers for Quakertown together are averaging 14 a game. So they're averaging as a team 32 points offensively. So there's not a lot of scoring power here. This is going to be a game, I think, that will be over very quickly. If Norristown is running on all cylinders, this game will be over. As Joe alluded to, the transition game, the running game, the pressure by Norristown should be lethal in the first quarter. If Norristown decides to put them away early, this could be a little more than a practice effort for Norristown tonight. There are only two scorers that are putting the points on the board for Quakertown, and they're averaging 7 a game. The leading scorer for them is averaging about 7 rebounds. The leading rebounder is about 7 per game. So I don't think there's going to be much competition here. As a coach, sometimes when you look back on these things, you would prefer having the actual practice in the game, because this sometimes you regress, you get into bad habits, and you get concerned by some of the things they do. Their concentration isn't there, the execution isn't there. The plus will be that Norristown should and could have the opportunity to mix and match the bench and utilize it. At this time of the year, you're looking to stretch your bench, and he should have plenty of time tonight to stretch the bench and get himself ready for the most important part of the season, the games coming up. Joe?
All right, thank you very much, Bob. We'll be back with tonight's tip-off in just a moment. For Bob Koch, this is Joe Hyland saying we'll see you shortly.
Good evening, and welcome to Norristown Area High School.
All right, welcome back for tonight's game between Quakertown and Norristown. It's a girls' game. We will be having the opening lineups, but first we'll all stand for the playing of the national anthem. right, we're about to introduce the starting five for their respective clubs.
Number 25, Rachel Dubuque.
Number 25 is Rachel Dubuque.
Number
team captain.
Lisa Ross.
Number 23 is Lisa Ross.
Number 34, Laurie Bryan.
Number 34 is Laurie Bryan.
Number 43, Steph Heimbach.
Number 43, the Panthers' tallest player is Stephanie Heimbach.
And number 40, Katie Quinn.
And number 40, Katie Quinn. Now for the Norristown Eagles.
And now for the Norristown Eagles. Number 4, Sasha Sims.
Number 4, the Eagles' leading rebounder, Sasha Sims, a 5'9 senior.
Number 5, Ashley O'Donnell.
Number 5, Ashley O'Donnell, a 6-foot sophomore.
Number 11, Tamara Halsey.
Number 11, Tamara Halsey, the Eagles'
number
leading assist
Danielle
person.
Marshall.
Number 22, Danielle Marshall,
number
Eagles' leading scorer. And number 33, a 5'9 freshman, Lamara Hinton, who shows exceptional promise.
While I have a moment, there's been a schedule change. Our game with Kennedy Kennedy for tomorrow night has been rescheduled for Monday night at 6 o'clock. 6 o'clock will be the JV game, followed by the varsity contest.
Coaches are giving their clubs last-minute instructions. As Bob alluded in the pregame, this game could be over very, very quickly. It all depends on how Quakertown responds to the Norristown's defensive pressure, which I think will be relentless this evening.
I would imagine for at least the first half it's going to be relentless. I think the closest you're going to see to score is the opening tap. After that, it's going to be a foot race.
And that's from a coach who has a state championship to his credit. A tap control by Quakertown. Ross.
Ooh.
Backcourt violation.
Oh, brother. And the interesting part is she looked at the first player, realized she couldn't, looked at the second, and the player wasn't over.
Here come the Eagles. Halsey, Marshall on the left wing, looks to drive, does drive. Ross with the rebound. Ross looks to run. Bounce pass to number 25. Very awkward layup. Here comes Marshall down the floor, stops. Misses the layup. There's a foul on the floor on Quakertown. Number 25, that's Rachel Dubuque. Halsey to inbound. Sims bangs off the rim. Halsey with the rebound. Here's Sims back to Halsey. Launches a three. 3-0 Eagles. Eagles in a press. Ross looking to break it. Number 25, Rachel Dubuque. Ball knocked out of bounds by Marshall. It'll be the Panthers' ball. Number 34 is Laurie Bryan. To Dubuque. Ross on the left wing. Quinn and Heimbach underneath. Heimbach on the left corner to Quinn. Nice pass. Too far underneath, Bob.
Too far underneath. The thing that's discouraging.
Halsey carried the ball.
At this level, we have a backcourt on the first series and passing the ball underneath on the third series. Just shouldn't be. It should not be.
All right, here's Heimbach. To Ross, stolen by the Eagles, the much taller Eagles. Here's Halsey, launches another three, bangs off the rim. There's a struggle under the boards. Possession arrow to Norristown.
It's five offensive rebounds already for Norristown, and we're a minute and a half into the game.
Marshall, long shot, missed badly. Here's Ross, slows it down. Here's Dubuque. Back to Ross. Heim back in the left corner. Inside to number 34, that's Laurie Bryan. Katie Quinn with the offensive rebound. There's a foul underneath on Norristown. It'll be foul is on number 4, Sasha Sims. That's her first. Bryan to inbound. Pass underneath. Rather rough foul on Stephanie Heimbach. Marshall, left wing, looks to drive, does drive. Pass inside, knocked down and stolen by the Panthers. Here's Dubuque. To Ross. Katie Quinn at the high post. Bryan, back to Quinn. Can't pass into that zone, Bob.
And she can't catch the ball. Twice they've gone to her and she's dropped the ball.
All right, it's 5-0, 5:25 left to play in the first quarter. Quakertown looks uncoordinated on offense.
It's uncoordinated is, I think, being Christian about it, Joe. The shot selection, when they've been able to take the shot, twice they've passed the ball to a player underneath the basket where she wouldn't be able to do anything with it. The backcourt violation, things that you really wouldn't think should happen, besides the fact we're 15 games into the varsity season at the varsity level, shouldn't occur. This would be a good opportunity for Norristown to work on things that they're not as good at. Maybe putting more time and working the ball into Ashley inside. Work on things that you know you're going to have to work on later.
There's a steal by Ashley O'Donnell. Fouled underneath. I'm sorry, offensive foul. Offensive foul on Ashley O'Donnell. Team second, her first. Long pass to Ross. Leads the break.
See, they went down on a 3-on-1, 3-on-2, and nothing happened. They didn't even get a shot out of it. They didn't split the court. There wasn't one on the right side, left side. There were three players on the right
on
side
the right
of the
side.
Court. And your options are limited.
Yeah. All right, here's Halsey. Sims looks to drive. Stops, pops. No good. Rebound to Ashley O'Donnell. Up and down. She traveled.
Those are the kind of things I'm talking about. Get the ball in Ashley's hand. Get her stronger. You're going to need her in the playoffs against stronger teams, more physical teams, better inside teams.
Yeah. Here's Ross, surrounded by three Eagles. Back to Laurie Bryan. Heim back to Dubuque. Looks to get around Marshall. Does get around Marshall. Pulls it back out again. Deep right corner. Katie Quinn with a 10-foot jump shot. 5-2, Norristown. Katie Quinn's, she must be about 6'1", 6'2"?
6'2", coach indicated 6'2", in the pregame.
There's a steal by Ross. Slows it down. Sets up the offense. Pass to Heimbach in the left corner. Looks to drive, does drive. Pass stolen by Ashley O'Donnell. Ashley O'Donnell and Katie Quinn are jockeying for position under there. Sasha Sims with a three. 8-2 Norristown. Here's Ross. Intense little player. Loses the ball out of bounds. She broke the press and threw the ball away.
What is interesting and surprising to me, Quakertown is playing man-to-man. I thought they would start out in the zone. and Norristown hasn't taken advantage of that, going inside or going to the basket. They're content taking threes, and Quakertown is looking to run the court.
Yeah.
They're pushing the ball up court.
That first step cost Marshall the ball. It's called for traveling. Katie Quinn, cross court to Ross. Ross looks to break the press and does. Circles back to Dubuque, top of the key. Here's Laurie Bryan, bothered by Halsey, bothered by Sims, who knocks it out of bounds. 3:24 left to play in the first quarter, 8-2 Norristown. Possession hour to Quakertown. Unless they pass the ball quicker, the person gets surrounded immediately by two or three Quakertown's
hurting themselves because they're getting ball to the corner and to the side. And that's the trap area, and that's going right to Norristown's strength. Get the ball to the middle of the court, and you're not going to be trapped as easily.
Here's Heimbach travel.
She's had a tough first couple minutes with passes, turnovers,
yes,
travels.
Sims, another three-point shot. 11-2. Here's Ross. Dubuque breaks for the basket. Ross doesn't see her. Another turnover for Quakertown.
And the point guard for Quakertown, Lisa Ross, is getting frustrated. She's yelling at her teammates. She's frustrated. And she was even pushing off, bringing it up court.
Yeah. Here's Marshall, stops, misses a 15-foot jump shot. Halsey with the offensive rebound. Nice pass inside to O'Donnell. Misses the layup. Katie Quinn with the rebound. Stolen by number 33, that's Lamara Hinton. A 5'9", a very promising 5'9 freshman.
I hope they got my quick hands on camera. Excuse me? If I could read your lips and pronounce and say it, I'd be in trouble.
All right, Dubuque with the ball, watched by Marshall. Ball was kicked. It'll be Quakertown's ball, 13-2. 2 minutes left to play in the first quarter. Bryan to take the ball out. Dubuque, watched by Marshall. Pass to Ross. There's another steal by Marshall. Put it in the book, put it in the book. Missed the layup. All right, that foul is on number 25, Rachel Dubuque. Foul called by referee Jen Dukenfield, who, in a pregame interview, informed me that she is distantly related to the great Philadelphia comedian W.C. Fields.
Is that right?
That is correct. W.C. Fields' original name was Dukenfield, and she claims to be a distant relative.
No wonder you were smiling, laughing so much in the pregame with the officials as I was the other side getting the book information. I knew I was missing out.
One of my favorite comedians, a man who said, a man who hates dogs and children can't be all bad. Nice pass inside. Foul by Lamara Hinton. Ross threaded a needle, got the ball underneath to Laurie Bryan, who drew the foul.
See, Joe, here's a thought on this. You know that it's 13-2. This game is in hand. As the coach of Norristown, you want to minimize the mistakes. You really want to be critical of your mistakes. Danielle Marshall, for example, in a travel with the person-to-person, the foul on that shot, on a non-shooter. Those are the kind of things you don't want to have happen, because against the CB East and the Cheltenhams, they're going to hurt
you. It's going to hurt you with that. Yeah, absolutely. All right, 13-3. Laurie Bryan made one of two. Pass inside to Ashley O'Donnell. There's a rebound taken by Dubuque. Long pass to Ross. Stops. Misses the short jump shot. It'll be Quakertown's ball under their own basket.
Danielle Marston and Brady State are in the game.
All right, Ashley O'Donnell's out of the game along with Lamara Hinton. Replaced by Brandy Statton. And number three, Xenia Pearson. Also out of the game for Quakertown is Katie Quinn.
See, that last foul, Joe, puts him at four with 1 minute left in the quarter, and he can't be pleased with that either. If that sustains itself, it's going to be in a bonus or better in the first half against a non-shooting team.
There's a long shot launched by Ross, rattles off the rim. It'll be white ball out of bounds. It'll be Norristown's ball out of bounds. Ball knocked off of Katie Weisel. All right, it's a 10-point Norristown lead. They have the game in hand already. Here's a tough drive. Misses the shot. Follow-up. That is number 21 over the top. That's a foul on Brandy Statton.
That's the fifth
foul. That's the fifth foul. Foul. 33 seconds left to play in the first quarter. Here's Dubuque. Here's Heimbach, saves the steal, back to Dubuque, looks to drive. Laurie Bryan rattles out, rebound Marshall. 15 seconds left to play. Slashes to the basket, stops, pops, 2 points, 15-3, Norristown. Here's a steal underneath. Number three, last second basket by Xenia Pearson, stole the pass, made the layup. 17-3, a 14-point Norristown lead, and it is, in a word, ugly.
I don't think it promises to get any better either. So what does Norristown do at this point? They have to substitute quite a bit. They want to mix and match, as I said, in the pregame. And I think Coach Jackson on timeouts has to remind his players, we have to perform, we have to execute. Lay off the fouls, no turnovers, we go to the basket, we make our layups. Ashley O'Donnell missed, I think, three layups in the first couple of minutes. He pulled her. Danielle Marshall, as I said, with the turnover. Those kind of things and the fouls should be addressed now, because you and I will see the competition, certainly in districts, but we'll see it with Cheltenham here in a week and a half, as you said, 10 days. And Cheltenham isn't going to make those kind of mistakes.
That's right. That's a totally different brand of Panther.
Very, very
different. At Cheltenham High School.
And those kind of mistakes against Cheltenham beat you.
All right, here's Laurie Bryan to take the ball out. She'll make the inbounds pass to Dubuque, to Ross. Norristown still with half-court pressure. Here's Laurie Bryan, looks to drive, stolen by Sasha Sims, who is in turn fouled by Katie Quinn. What year is she, Bob? Number 40.
I don't know, Joe. I'm not sure on that. Number
40 for 40? Katie Quinn. Big girl, tall girl. Danielle drills a 12-foot jump shot. 19-3. Norristown ratchets down the defensive pressure. There's a pass to Laurie Bryan. Goes into the corner. That's quicksand over there. You can't go in there.
Well, maybe we should take a lottery on what the score could be at this pace. If they continue to run and press, they're not even working the ball around. Last two possessions, Norristown's taking a shot with one pass.
Right. There's another bad pass. Number 20 walked for Quakertown. That's Kim Longacre. You know, I know they're overmatched, Bob. I know Quakertown is overmatched, but it takes a lot of courage to go up against a buzzsaw like Norristown. Knowing you're overmatched, but still going out there and giving your best. You got to respect that. Got to respect that.
These kids at this level have to give it their best. They don't belong on the court. That's expected no matter what's happened. Joe, my first year coaching, one of the teams that we coached against beat us 100-20.
Wow.
And
wow,
you know,
yep,
what's that saying?
Yeah.
I mean, we didn't stop hustling, we got shellacked, but you got to keep playing the game.
Mm-hmm.
You have to keep coaching too.
Yes. There's a pass inside, skips off Xenia's hands. It'll be Quakertown's ball, down by 16 points. Across the timeline. Here's Ross. Katie Quinn, top of the key. Here's Ross, top of the key. Laurie Bryan, right wing.
They can't wait to get rid of the ball with the pressure. They can't wait to get rid of it.
There's an errant pass. It'll be Norristown's ball out of bounds. Ross threw it away. Halsey, top of the key, drained a 14-foot jump shot.
Two passes, jump shot. About 8 seconds used on the clock.
Here's Dubuque, hawked by any number of Eagles. Here's Quinn, into the corner. Number 20 misses the shot. Quinn misses the follow-up.
Going to pick up her second foul.
Going to pick up her second foul.
Yep. She reached. Yep.
And a young lady that size is going to get noticed. If she makes a foul, she's going to get noticed. Sims misses a jump shot, follows her own
miss.
She
used the backboard on that shot. Nope.
All right, here's a foul. Katie Quinn will be going to the line. No, not yet. Yes, she will. Quakertown is in the 1-1.
To Quakertown's credit, Joe, they're still playing man-to-man.
Yes.
But I don't believe Norristown is taking advantage of that by shooting the jump shots and the threes. Instead of going to the basket, establishing an inside game, they're content with threes and jump shots.
Nice shot. Katie Quinn makes the first of two. It's 21-4. Makes them both. Nice stroke. Here's Halsey, works the baseline, draws a foul. I think that... That's Katie Quinn's second foul, the team's fifth. Tamara Halsey will be on the line to shoot two. Spills out on the first shot. Coach Jackson's going to his bench.
So at the 5-11 mark, it's 21-5, right? 17 fouls versus 16 fouls.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Misses them both. Here's Dubuque, top of the key. Another steal by Halsey. Lead pass to Marshall, put it in the book. 23-5. Norristown with 11 steals. Got away with a double dribble. Pass cross court.
Jeez. Now, at what point do you back off for the press? How long do you keep it going?
This is one of the most overmatched teams I've ever seen. This is one of the most overmatched games I've ever seen. I mean, it's not even close.
Go! Go! Win! Go! Fight! Win! Go!
All right. Fight. Here's Dubuque.
Win! Go! Fight! Win! Go!
Katie Quinn.
Fight.
Number 35 misses a layup. Number 35 is Kate Weisel.
If I'm not mistaken, she played on the JV game.
I think she did.
Right. Correct. She was the leading rebounder, I think, in the JV game.
Here's a short jump shot. Ball's on the floor. Here's number 22 with the ball, Kelly Duke to Dubuque. Duke to Dubuque.
Oh, brother. You know, he's not happy with that. Just threw the shirt down. He can't be happy with that.
All right, number 22. Kelly Duke will be going to the line. I believe it's Kelly Duke will be shooting.
It's only Tamara's first, but it's the team's eighth. It's conceivable that they'll be in a bonus. Quakertown will be in a bonus in the first half, shooting a two-shot on a foul.
3:36 to play. Dubuque on the line. Makes the first. Nice smooth stroke. All right, here's a scramble underneath. Ball picked out by Norristown. Marshall picking cherries. Here's Halsey. Forces up a jump shot. Rebound, tough rebound to Katie Quinn. Kelly Duke stolen by Xenia Pearson. Marshall on the break. Tamara Halsey. All right, Daniel Marshall got the offensive rebound, drew a foul. Foul on number 40, I believe, Katie Quinn.
Which may bring to the table another issue. That's two Norristown players that have gone to the floor. You don't want to have an injury in this kind of game. Get your other players in, give them the time.
Daniel Marshall.
You're not going to lose anything. The only thing you do is pad the board, put some points on. Get your other players on the court.
Danielle Marshall makes the first of two. Back into the game is number 34, Laurie Bryan, along with Steph Heimbach. Number four, Sasha Sims back in the game, along with number 20. That'll be Lauren Hughes. There's a timeout on the floor with 3:06 left to play in the second quarter. Norristown 24, Quakertown 6.
Let's go, Jackson is pumping the official.
Tamara went hard to the floor. Looked like she got hammered.